And Australia remains in caretaker mode, and it's likely to be another week before we know who our Prime Minister is. The four crossbench MPs who will determine who governs are having their first face-to-face meeting tomorrow.
Julia Gillard has the Prime Minister's jet and the office, but she's still waiting on the mandate from the Australian people.
Government is continuing in line with the caretaker conventions.
Tony Abbott's in Canberra too.
Hello, Mr. Abbott. What's the plan today?
Both leaders are locked in the most extraordinary negotiations of their political lives to convince these independents to join their team and form a government. Just days ago, not too many Australians knew who Rob Oakeshott was. He's now one of the most powerful people in the country.
We are getting absolutely bombarded by media requests, not only nationally but internationally now.
Bob Katter is likely to side with the coalition, but he won't do it without giving them a touch-up first.
I'll work with people that I personally despise, to be quite frank with you, if necessary.
Tony Windsor's angry at everyone as well.
This is the worst political campaign that I've ever seen. I think the political hypocrisy in relation to both leaders was appalling.
The state of play is unlikely to change for at least a week. It will come down to recounts and postal votes. Currently, Labor has 72 confirmed seats. The Coalition, 70. Four seats are in doubt, and both parties are sweating on those seats.
However one of those seats falls, each one of those makes a difference in the way the negotiations are going to be played out.
The independents are meeting in Canberra for the first face-to-face talks tomorrow. Natasha Rexall, 10 News.